The OfficeSafe interface might look simple, but behind it lies some hidden tips that can make or break your simulation before it even starts. If you've never opened OfficeSafe and you're unsure what these windows do or where to begin, this video is for you. I'll walk you through the full interface, how to import your model, assign material properties, and perform fatigue analysis. And along the way, I'll share the key techniques and overlooked settings that experienced users rely on so you can get accurate results and avoid common rookie mistakes. Let's jump in. Okay, let's try to open the OfficeSafe. When we open the OfficeSafe, this is the first window that pops up, and here shows the project name. You can define that. So I would name it example and say create. It creates a project for me, and this is pretty much everything you need in this window. What I like most about OfficeSafe is you have everything in just one window. You don't need to hover through different pages or like different modules. You have different tabs or shortcuts here, and you can use everything. Okay, to start with, we need to open the finite element file. So from FEA solutions, you go to open finite element model and you open the file. And as you see here, it gives you different formats such as Abacus ODB or Simpac FBI file, ANSYS file, NASRAM file, or different options. Let's put this one as an example. And you say, do you want to pre-scan? And you say yes, and it starts scanning your model. Here you have different options. Here you can have elemental, nodal, or integration point. Let's put it on elemental for now. And you can check or uncheck different things here if you want. You can check this one. You have different steps here or increment. You can activate and deactivate things here. And just check OK. Click on OK. And a new window pops out. Here it says use the stress units. You have to do that according to your file. So if your FEA file was megapascal, so you need to put this value on megapascal. If it was in pascal or kilopascal, you need to change that. If you choose this one wrong, it gives you inaccurate results. So this is very important. And you click on OK, and you need to check yes. And it gives you all the groups you have in your FEA file. So we have the element surface. Here it's better to create a set using all the nodes or elements in Abacus OfficeSafe analysis. But here we can use this one, or we can have different nodes or elements here. It has some support files, set one, stuff like that. As this one is just an example for the interface, we just click on OK on one of which. You'll have proper examples in future. Okay, on the left hand side, it shows you the different groups or subgroups we have. And let's say we want to define the material properties. Here we have the material. It says undefined. You can use the material database on the right hand side. You have different options here. You have Dang Van model, SN curve sample, or you can have different materials according to different standards. For instance, the FKM guideline, you see different materials here. Or the best option of OfficeSafe is you can have the steel weld fatigue properties here. Let's select something here. If we select this one here and we double click on this one, you say, are you sure do you want to change the material properties? And if you say yes, you have the material properties here. And if you click on this arrow, you can see the material properties. Let's open another one. For instance, here in the system, we can have SA1005, and we can use it for this one. And if we go here, you see the algorithm we can use are Brown-Miller and Morrow. Here you have the elastic modulus in megapascal. You have the Poisson's ratio or text, different comments to see, for instance, if the material is Martens attack, stuff like that. It can be very useful, but these values are the values used for the analysis, K prime, N prime, B, and C. These are very important. We'll get to that later when it comes to fatigue analysis videos. So the next thing to select is the algorithm. If we double click on the algorithm and select an algorithm to be used, We can select different things. We have different options, tons of options here, to be honest. We have biaxial strain life, HCF and LCF, high cycle fatigue, low cycle fatigue. We can have normal strain Morrow Walker for the finite life, mean stress correction, or we can have the infinite life such as Goodman and Gerber here. There are different theories behind them. You can go ahead and start learning them, but I will teach you about that in the next videos. We have the Bramiller Morrow here. We have Fatemi Sushi, and here for the biaxial stress, we have normal stress. As you see, we have different options here. Tons of different options. We can have uniaxial stress. We just select one randomly to show you how to select the algorithm. So as you see, the algorithm changed for this one. After we defined everything here, we can go to the loading settings. We have the loading here, the loading scale here, or we can change that. If you want to clear that, we just right click here and clear all loadings. And if you say yes, you see there's no loads here. You can generate the load history from here, generation. If you want to have, for instance, the signal or sign generation, you can have this one. This is the time, the frequency, number of waves. And if you click on OK, you see here we have one sign loading. And if you right click on it and say plot, you see we have a fully reversed signed loading, so that you have an idea of the load history from this one. Once you've done that, you can go here to the data set and select the final increment. You select this one, say add a load data set, and as you see, the data set is created. Most of the time we use the final one because it's the final step, and we have the loading here. You can also navigate through the amplitude, and you can do whatever you want to this one. You can scale an offset, you can add offset value to this one, or do anything you want. Then after you've done everything, you're good to do the analysis. As we didn't mean to perform any fatigue analysis, we don't need to analyze something here. We can have other stuff here. For instance, if you go to the weld preparation, you can define and analyze weld geometry. For instance, here you can have the weld group or anything like that. Here we can have different options in the tools. For instance, we can have a macro, we can play a macro to use some automation, or we can import the plugin. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe to the channel to see more similar content. Don't forget to click on the video on screen before it ends. Stay tuned. See you in the next one.